fact that it's here, I know you've been at several shows here in the Bord Gáis Energy Theatre, but it's a fantastic arena.
It is, it's a great arena. I've been at a lot of shows here, but this time I'm going to be a bit more nervous because it's going to be a bit more exciting. You know, it's going to be such an amazing show, and for the people to come see you guys, and like the XL arena all over again.
Yeah, so you were back there on Sunday night, of course, that was brilliant. Pete mentioned the fact that you've touched on it about starting your preparations, but you are back in the gym already. You haven't exactly been away.
No, yeah, we've been training really hard over the last few months. We had 4 weeks off after the game as well. We've been back up quite a bit now, but it's been hard to get consistency a few weeks in because of the business in the last few weeks. But after Christmas, I'm just going to get stuck in with them and just start focusing on this fight.
Yeah, because it's serious stuff. This is it's the road to Rio starts already. It's a long time away, but it's not.
Yeah, this is it. This is where all the hard training begins. This is where all the demands are won in this phase of training. So it's so important just to get your head down, start focusing on the training, and hopefully the performances will come out. You don't just turn up on the night and say able to perform. This is where all the demands are won.
Mick mentioned the fact that you were at an event recently and there's hundreds and thousands of kids around you. What's been the most surprising aspect of your success? What has just kind of blown you away? Is it that reaction from everyone?
Yeah, I think so. Just can't believe the effect that having people really and just hearing the stories of where people were when you're watching fly, what they're doing, and just the emotions that everyone felt when I won. And it was such an emotional time, but I've never realised how much of an impact I
have
back here as well. It's
really
amazing.
And Katie, what about the celebrity lifestyle? You had it before, but it's on a
celebrity.
Yeah, well, listen, that's what it is. But it does take, I read other people talking about it, but it takes a while to get used to that you can't just kind of walk down the street anymore. People want to stop you, they want to wish you well and say hello.
Yeah, it's been a bit surreal, really. It's been crazy. That's probably the most difficult part about it, to be honest. But so nice, and as I said, yeah, I just come up wishing you well all the time, and it does take a bit of time to get used to, it's a good complaint, I think.
Yeah. And the awards, rightly, they keep coming. I know you were in Armenia last week, Pete mentioned it, the IABA Women's Boxer of the Year, you were at the BBC Sports Awards the other night, the RT ones are coming up on Sunday as well, just to remind you. You don't need reminding of that, but you know, these things, I mean, you take them in your stride, but you're massively honoured by all of these things.
Yeah, it's huge honour really to be invited to these things and to get the awards as well. Just this year, the Women's Boxing has been such a huge year for the sport, and it's been the best year possible for the sport. And just seeing how much of an effect that Women's Boxing has had on everyone throughout the whole world, really, since it's been incredible. And it's been a privilege to be part of such a great journey over the last few years.
And look, we saw it at the Worlds, we saw it at the Olympic Games. I know, I think in the press release you speak about it, about the competitors. You're there to be shot at. They want to get at you all the time, and the gap is closing. But, you know, some of the other nations who have very talented women's boxers, they're investing hugely in their boxers.
Yeah, I mean, it's only going to get hard over the next few years, and that's why I just have to continue to keep improving all the time. That's why we're working hard every single day in the gym, and it's my job to stay at the top and keep one step ahead of everyone else, and I plan to defend me all the titles over the next few years and defend me with the title 4 years time.
Absolutely, the road to Rio starts right here. Ladies and gentlemen, Katie's time is limited, as she mentioned, and Pete mentioned that the training has started already and they have appointments afterwards. What I'm going to do for the next few minutes, because Katie's time is limited, if ladies and gentlemen, you'd like to throw a few questions at Katie or Pete or Mick or Brian, please take the opportunity to do it while it's there for the next few minutes if you'd like to do that.
Sorry.
Yes, Jerry.
Do you have a preference for instance, is there someone that you haven't met yet?
Yeah, I'm happy to box anyone, to be honest, but I think it would probably be nice to get a different opponent. Just, I don't really know who was out there, to be honest, with that, looking at opponents, but the way I'm looking at fight the likes of Queen Unwin many people, I think she might have her national championships on at that time, but I'd like to get someone really exciting over to, you know, people in a really exciting fight, and someone who's going to stand there and fight and box the nice exciting. I find that too exciting, hopefully. Yeah, we're hoping they are, that someone really, obviously in the top 10 and a little.
One other question, would you like to paint a women's fashion?
Yeah, I think it is going to start next year. I think we're talking to Dr. Will over in Armenia, and he's going to, we're talking to him about that, and hopefully the WSB will start for him next year. To be brilliant. Thanks again, so that way that the lads are getting as well.
Anyone else? I could stay up here all day and ask questions. I'm not sure about that yet at this stage. Brian might be able to tell you more, I don't know. Would you like to tell more?
No.
Okay. CBC?
Give us a week or two.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, fortunately enough, I've been back and forth with Matthew Macklin, challenge for world title, and young Patrick Highland last weekend, challenge for a very gallant effort, and I've been back and forth for America. There is a chance also that Katie could fight maybe in America as an amateur on some of the big shows, or possibly Madison Square Garden, or even Vegas, Las Vegas as well. So there's all time, but I suppose just to get the show on the road, this is the first one to get it. To get the show on the road. Yeah, that was another, but just with dates, and I suppose Katie's eager to get back in the ring, and just with availability of dates. So the O2 could still be a possibility. We're expecting this, should sell fairly swiftly. We could look at the O2, or we could indeed. A lot of the amateurs and a lot of the Olympians are fighting in around that time, which didn't make it ideal, but we kind of had to go anyway. But if we went to the O2, we could do, a night of the Olympians where you could have all the guys back. And what we were favouring was an Ireland against the English team. So that would have been quite interesting as well. So we're working on them few things as well. Hopefully maybe later on in the first half of the year, later on in the year, they could be all possible.
Do you
think you'll
be able to enjoy Christmas to the full, like Christmas Day or all that? Will you be training very hard?
I think I have 2 or 3 days off on Christmas, so I definitely don't know Christmas Day. Last Christmas, I only have Christmas Day off, and I was training all the way through, and the next day, I have a Christmas day off actually because it's a Sunday as well.